Hi, so everyone, welcome again to The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, and with the following expansion after Hearts of Stone, Blood and Wine. I just finished drinking a ton of coffee because that's my fuel of the morning. I've also been very sick these past 2 weeks. For some reason, this horrible cough will never get off me, but as you remember last time, we encounter something very particular. A very interesting character, or should I say, a new kind of monster. A Bruxa, I can't even pronounce that shit, but who cares. And it was very interesting fighting this new type of vampire. And we're gonna delve back into the story. Again, I guess this is one of my, it has to be one of my most favorite, because it's a complete new map. And it's just, I mean, what I did with this game so far, man, it's just, it's incredible. I can never mention enough to see how much they actually add to this game. And it's just fantastic. It's truly fascinating. It's truly fantastic. And here we're about to finish loading. Eavesdropping. I never tried that, eavesdropping. Anyway, here we are. And I was able to pick some monster components, not a whole lot. I believe, yeah, I'm out of potions. I just gotta rest again. It's not a big deal. So let's get out of here now. We gotta go the Beast of Toussaint. We gotta find Palmarine and ask him to take you to the Duchess. Okay, so let's do that. There's a plan here. Must be upstairs. Yeah, it's gonna be upstairs. It's gotta be out of this dungeon. You know what? I haven't explored this far, so let's just give it a quick go. I don't want to take too long, but maybe we find something here. So this is a new map. Oh, it's just a dead end now. Okay. So it was straight to the point. Why is there like a... Huh. Let me see that. See that? There's like a... You see the map? It's like an entrance there. Okay. Maybe fire? That's very strange. Let me use the sword. Okay, so that's very weird. Okay, whatever. I'm not gonna take too long. Let's go back. Let's go back to this. Let's get back to find Roach. What are you eating, man? What are you eating? By the way, this is I know it's not brown. That's because this is the one that the king, Ciri's father gave to me as a, you know, I guess it's a show of thanks for helping him save his daughter. It's supposed to be a better breed or something, but that's why he's not brown. And actually, because I never did the game plus, so I kind of want to make another completely walkthrough with, you know, starting from zero all the way down to like a new game plus. Stop stopping like that, damn it, horse.
Slow.
We gotta go up. You know what? There's a plan here. Let me see what is that. It might be new. You have to get up from that side, Geralt, really? Can you get couldn't you just get up from the left side, man? Honeysuckle. Let's turn the fire on. Can I turn the fire on? You can't? What? You can't turn the get out. Get up. Ooh, I can hear a crowd. Yes! Quidditch! No, oh, this is not Harry Potter, my bad. It's not Harry Potter. Can you imagine Quidditch in this game? That would be awesome.
Oh.
I'm sorry, people. I'm sorry. You can see the horse from far away. You can get out. Come on, you can move out on time. You know there's, horses around this time, man. Seriously, people, what in the world? Oh, I just skipped the part where she goes to go.
Faster.
Okay, Kido, you're retarded. You're stupid. You're supposed to move away when you see a guy with a horse. I'm not supposed. I mean, I can't control the horse. I mean, I can, but you know what I'm saying. Ooh la la, ooh la la, ooh la la. My name is Gerald. What, can we talk? Can we just have a conversation? Can we just, like, I mean, I don't mean anything bad. I kill monsters for a living. You don't want to talk to me? You don't want to? Oh, whatever. I got Jennifer. Okay, so I'm supposed to talk to who?
Oh!
Oh, I'm not stupid. She's right there talking to the kids.
Need to speak to the Duchess urgently.
Yes.
All right, you scamps. Story's done. Go find your parents.
But the Pomerine. What about the story of Riddick and the dragon?
Riddick?
The tales for another time. But take a good look at the man who stands before you now.
Riddick.
This is Geralt of Rivia, the master witcher who lent his valiant hand to the defeat of the giant Goliath.
Master Witcher, is it true virtue always trumps villainy?
Yeah, virtue always trumps. No, the stronger wins. Not always, but it's worth being good. Actually, I would go and say the stronger wins. I mean, that's the logical assumption when you think about it. Yes.
Much as we might not.
I mean, regardless
like
what you want
to
do, good or not.
Oh,
the stronger always wins, my friends.
Is there no point to being virtuous?
Not what I said.
Then what's needed
exactly
to vanquish villains?
A sharp sword.
And some skill. Hell yeah.
Lots of villains, and they've sharp swords too. And lots of skill.
That's where virtue.
Then you run away.
As they say, the gods reward the virtuous after death. Now, that will do for questions. Go find your parents.
Yeah, how come there's a bunch of kids without supervision? That is bad. Bad thing.
Your Mighty Highness has doubtless arrived at the tourney grounds to watch the battle in the
arena. That woman is crying.
If we hurry, we'll be in time to speak with her before the spectacle begins.
What's she crying for?
Lead the way.
Oh, someone's fighting me again.
Who's fighting? Elf Guardian gladiators?
Close, but not quite. As you will soon see.
Oh man, what is that?
Someone's gonna fight a Shalmar. He's gonna put some bells on its tail to confuse it, slow it down.
Whatever is the problem? The beast is a gift from the Emperor, I guess.
Well, I don't know about that thing, so I can't say if it's dangerous. It looks dangerous. Shouldn't torture it like that. I don't have compassion for monsters, I guess. But that looks like a living creature. Doesn't look like it's harming nobody. It just looks like it was in cage, and then nothing's the matter. I want to say shouldn't torture it like that. Be noble.
Shouldn't torment the beast. How would you like to be dumped in an arena?
You, a witcher.
I slay monsters who are a threat to humans. You're out to humiliate.
That's what I thought. That's exactly what I thought.
No knight will gain any glory from this.
Sure. Exactly. Exactly right. You're right, Richard. I mean, he's not harming nobody. He's just getting caged, man. Okay, I want to know who the fuck is gonna.
Who's going to fight the beast?
Yeah, who's gonna do that?
Guillaume, the young man, you bet.
Yeah. Mentioned he promised his heart's capture a monster trophy.
Great love demands great sacrifices.
Well, let's go see the Duchess.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. It almost sounds like Batman. It's like he's trying to approach Batman. It's technically Batman, but in a medieval era. Except that he doesn't do justice for all, just kills monsters. That is a goofy armor.
We can see your trousers!
I dedicate my imminent victory
Don't
to
Don't you have any
Lady
shame?
Vivian.
It's begun.
Something tells me that I'm gonna have to jump and help this damsel in distress little boy. That is a very interesting looking armadillo. Why is he blindfolded?
Got a bad feeling about this.
Oh yeah, me too. He said he's blindfolded. I don't think he's going nice. Yeah, why don't you come down and help the guy? Huh? Just clapping like that. Showing his skills. I got a ooh, no. No, 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 no. Dude, watch your back. Hey, you're back! Well, that's what you get for being fucking gallant, dumbass.
We have to help him.
Time to be the hero, Witcher. He's just gonna sit there. Oh no, he did jump.
Onward!
Gotta keep it down.
Oh yeah, you can crawl like that's that fast. So smart, man.
To give fight to the beast, its plans confound.
Is that the spooks? No, 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 that's not what I meant.
All our hopes, alas, had turned to dust.
How long you gonna make
it? And set fire to the woods. For nothing in this struggle.
Yeah, you see that shit? It looks.
Well, it was all.
It takes him almost like not even half a second to crawl up. I don't have. Save, yeah. That sounded like, well, what am I complaining? It's not realistic. It's just a game, but he just curled up, and it was not even half a second. Where is he? It's heavy. He needs some momentum to roll and keep going. You know what I'm saying? Like, look more. Oh my God, are you serious?
Gotta keep it down.
I guess he has to hit the wall. What I wanted.
The fate of the beast has been weighed by the gods. Soon the witches will triumph against all odds.
What am I using that? You idiot. Let me use green. Close.
Like fool, like a bow who leaps at the lobster's spurt, so the witch.
Man, that guy is holding good. Certain rocks. Oh, he's almost dead. What? He's so fast. Oops, oops, here we go. Oh my god, that was close. He's bleeding. There you go. Good. That was a lot of fun. An armadillo covered in rock.
The Shelma lies defeated by Geralt of Rivia, master of the witchering trade.
Yeah.
Behold, as the last gasps of life seep from the beast.
Yeah, with my glasses untouched. Not even a single crack.
Master Geralt, do what you must. Finish the deed.
I'm not gonna kill it. That beast was just being hanging there for no reason. Poor
Monster's
creature.
No threat. No need to kill it.
Yeah, fuck you.
A victor may always show mercy. It is his right. Long live Geralt the Merciful. Pikeman, see to the beast.
That beast, he was just probably, you know, wandering in the lands, minding his own business, and someone just snatched him. Seriously, that poor armadillo was not hurting nobody.
Guillaume, the lads came damned close to dying.
I'm fine. Not hurt at all. Vivian?
Smile as befits a hero and keep silent. Speech clearly paints you. She approaches.
I mean, it was not a threat to humans, obviously it was, because we forced it, but...
Talk.
That's not the creature's fault.
Vivian, you shall talk later, in the medic's tent.
Geralt, magnificent, breathtaking.
Your grace.
Something tells me that bitch is the vampire queen.
Brilliant idea. We are delighted, ravished to have struck upon it.
Something tells me that.
Honored.
See to our young hero. Hop, hop. For we must make off with Geralt. We should talk. We had been long awaiting your arrival, had nearly lost hope. Then suddenly, that entrance, so spectacular.
Exactly, that's exactly what I'm about to say, because... Seriously, man, seriously, why are we doing this? That creature, I mean, unless you're surviving and you need to kill it for, I don't know, some kind of material, yeah, entertainment, man. Fuck.
Your grace.
Am I wrong with that, guys? Am I wrong with that? Can you guys tell me about that? Is it wrong?
Nonsense.
To actually think that way?
Knights have battled beasts for mere glory since time immemorial. True. Guillaume suffered a few bumps, scars, and bruises, but in return gained eternal glory as he who slew the monster.
Mm-hmm. What about the crowd? Say the Shalemar had vaulted into the stands. Would have been a massacre.
Exactly.
Though we value your fortuitous intervention in the arena, we would remind you your services have been retained, and as shall soon become clear, you will be generously compensated for completing another task altogether.
Okay. What about the contract?
My contract. I'd like to discuss it.
Naturally, but not here. We shall need Damien.
Shoo-shoo.
He let the investigation pending your arrival. But wherever could he be? Come, we must find him.
He looks so dope with those glasses, seriously. I'm sorry, buddy. I mean, I guess I could have killed him and get something out of him, like a trophy or a sword, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna do that on a different walkthrough.
Tell us, have you come alone? Or did Viscount Julian accompany you?
Mm-hmm.
Wish to see Dandelion, your grace?
Yes. I mean, no. Yes. But solely to tell him we regret. Yes, deeply regret rescinding the death sentence we so justly handed down upon him.
Of course.
If we could turn back time, we would make certain he sat in a tower till he rotted. No, we would ensure he was broken on the wheel, then drawn, hanged, and quartered.
Why were you ordered to kill him? I can't remember that.
Ah, the
The very man we would entrust.
She's just walking around like that with no guard. Well, I guess the witcher is there to help.
Captain of my personal guard.
Your grace, witcher.
Greetings.
Yeah, let me tell him about that, so that way he doesn't go and
sorry to
spend
have to
his
tell
time.
You, but the guardsman handling the last victim's body.
I know already. The creature in the cellar of Corvo Bianco. Was it the beast?
No. A Bruxa, a kind of vampire. Not the beast, but tied to it in some way.
You know this how?
Through careful analysis of the evidence, both on the riverbank and at Corvo Bianco.
Do you mean to insinuate the investigation thus far has been sloppy?
Geralt insinuates nothing of the sort. We must listen to him attentively.
Of course. Ugh.
I examined the body of the beast's last victim. Might have found something. Need to analyze it. A quiet place, that's what I could use most right now. And maybe the help of an alchemist or a mage. Also like to hear all you know about the previous victims. Take it Sir Delatour is my man for that.
Firstly, call me Damien, please. Secondly, you should know I spoke against summoning you here. I've heard much about you. You bring trouble, or thus far have, always. And we've enough trouble as it is. Yet we are capable of defeating the beast on our own, without an outsider's help. I've no doubt about it.
Damien, we settled the matter of the Witcher's employ some time past. Definitively. Since you have broached it nonetheless, let us discuss Geralt's pay. Are the legends true?
Hell yes.
Do Witchers usually demand that which you find at home? Yet did not expect.
Okay, call me stupid. What is that supposed to mean? That which you find at home, yet did not expect. I'm gonna say yes. Fuck it. Say yes.
Yes, Your Grace. The law of surprise. Time honored.
We shall be counted. The surprises we encounter on a daily basis would be of no value to one such as you. What awaits at the palace are edicts to sign and portraits of suitors from far-off lands. I fear you would find little use for either. Thus, we've decided you shall receive the deed to a vineyard, Corvo Bianco, and a sum of coin. You will doubtless consider this adequate. Title to the vineyard shall be given to you at once.
Oh,
surely
nice.
You'll need lodgings while you hunt. The coin, however, will be yours only once you have slain the beast.
Lovely,
nice.
Generous gesture, Your Grace. Corvo Bianco. Isn't it the Duchy's temporary morgue?
Is it now? The Chancellery's bungled things again, we fear. Not to be left unsupervised for one instant. Yet, in its mood, a morgue should present minimal problems to a witcher. What's more, nothing enhances a wine's reputation better than a grim legend.
Thank you, Your Grace.
Something tells me that dude is hiding
something. As I said before, I'll need some information.
I'm just making my assumption, guys. I'm not saying that's what it is. I'm just saying that's my hunch. Okay, the beast first victim, what do we know? Okay, let's talk about the first.
How did it start? Who was the first victim?
Crespi was the first to die. He was famed once for his many glorious tournament victories. Then he grew old, hung up his sword, and took to winemaking.
Crespi was not loved by the wine merchants. He was ruthless in business and thought to cheat many a time. He asked us for a dispensation from all court ceremonies. We did not grant it. We could not. Once you've taken the oath of a knight, you remain a knight till death.
How'd he die? Where'd they find the body?
Quite unusual, the circumstance. He was at a feast when suddenly one of his fellow feastgoers noticed he was missing. The town watch found him an hour later. On his hands and knees, propped against the town pillory, his sword hanging from his neck. He had died of wounds inflicted with claws, not a weapon. Blows of great force.
So he died suddenly, but the body was on its knees. Meaning someone posed it.
So it seems.
Mm-hmm. Maybe he... Okay, I got... I still have my assumptions. I still have some. Okay, be a second victim. Tell me about it.
Second murder. Tell me what you know.
In the city, there are certain nooks. No one reasonable ventures there after dark. Ramon Dulac's corpse was found in one such place. With the first murder, terror gripped the city. Its inhabitants grew wary, kept to safe areas. Consequently, news of the second victim came to us from a group of concerned cutpurses.
Criminals fear the beast? Telling in a way. Take it you've excluded the possibility that Ramon died at the hands of these bandits.
Do you believe me, an amateur? Not hands, but claws killed Ramon Dulac. The wound was deep, clean.
His body was found in the gutter, dressed in nightshirt and cap, a pillow placed under his head, and his sword replaced by a bed warmer. Ramon Dulac, a knight who but a dozen years past was an advisor to our father, the Duke.
Someone went to a lot of trouble to make him look ridiculous. Maybe revenge was the motive.
It's not out of the question. Dulac had shady dealings with the criminal underworld, but no one ever came forth with concrete proof of any misdoings.
Okay, so both of them were knights.
So, first two victims were knights, best years behind them.
The same could be said of the third. Sir Delacroix was wont to claim that in modern times, knights face new challenges, enterprise being the latest addition to the chivalric virtues.
He made a veritable fortune in the grain trade. Palmerin even nicknamed him Sir de la Stinchy.
Found a coin pouch on his body. Contained florins dating from various times, hailing from different provinces of the Empire.
Delacroix loved coin, true, but had no patience for numismatics.
Okay, there's a lot of similarities.
Lots of similarities between the victims. All the bodies were found in strange places, under extraordinary circumstances. Seems the murderer, whoever or whatever it is, has some meaning to convey.
These were honorable men. We are horrified by the disdain, the disrespect with which they were treated. These were knights of Toussaint. Blast it!
Might be the point. From what you say, none was a model of virtue. Ever considered that's what the beast's trying to draw attention to?
All the murdered men were knights who swore fealty to the five chivalric virtues. And even if the...
Knights of Toussaint swear fealty to what virtues, exactly?
Honor, wisdom, generosity, valor and compassion.
Okay, why those exactly? Tell me that.
Five virtues. Why are they so important to your knights?
Strange question.
Your Grace, forgive me. I'm a foreigner trying to understand another land's customs.
Correct.
You are forgiven. According to legend, the virtues we cultivate were bestowed upon us by the Lady of the Lake. How we truly came to espouse them, none remember. In Toussaint, we believe men of low birth should be simple-hearted and obedient. We expect much more, however, of our knights. They are to be soldiers and courtiers, lords and servants. Thus, the need for clear moral guidelines. At the time of his dubbing, a knight vows to demonstrate, throughout his life, honor, wisdom, generosity, valor, and compassion.
Yeah, it seems very normal with knights' customs.
Beast seems to be pointing up moral decay, denouncing it. Victims were all humiliated. Might have been murdered to emphasize their lack of specific chivalric virtues.
Honor, compromised by the pillory. Wisdom, by ridicule. Generosity by a coin pouch shoved down a throat. It seems to fit, true.
Yeah.
Though not perfectly.
Why not?
Can't discount the theory if it's on the lips of everyone in town. Say our reasoning's right. Next murder will be just as showy and denounce the victim's lack of the fourth virtue, valor. We can also assume that victim will be an elder knight.
Let's think. At the moment, all the knights are either at the tourney grounds or in the palace gardens. Our annual hare hunt shall begin there shortly. Have you heard of the custom?
Milton mentioned something. Seemed excited to prance around in a bunny costume. Not sure why. Hang on. Strange circumstances. A knight advanced in years. The famed cowardice of rabbits.
Could it be that simple? Is Milton de Peyrac Peyren the next victim?
Milton also knew Delacroix. Told me so down by the river.
Damien! To me, something so obvious. De Peyrac Perrin, Crespi, Delacroix, and Delac formed the knightly team. It was years ago, but...
Okay, what does that mean? No, no, don't stop now. Just tell me.
They were a team?
They were close friends, tightly knit, and as such, earned the trust of our father, the Duke. We often witnessed him turn to them with delicate matters. Later, their paths diverged.
Unlikely to be a coincidence. Beast must know it too. It's a lead, I'm sure.
Okay.
Your Grace, we need to find Melton immediately.
Rather problematic. You see, the garden entertainments are due to start, and he's disguised as the Hare, hiding somewhere, waiting for some tipsy courtiers to find him. The Hare's hiding place is a carefully guarded secret.
We must call off the game.
First and foremost, we must remain calm.
You lying.
Damien, order the garden searched immediately, but discreetly. By no means can we disrupt the festivities. Panic will only incite the beast to strike sooner.
Well, yeah, she's got a point there.
And you, Witcher, follow me. My gardens, my night, I shall take the fall. A murder is out of the question. I will not allow it. Not near my palace. Horses! Ready our horses!
Did she just told the horses to ready up the horses? That'll be funny, a horse riding another horse. Oh, why are you tripping, woman?
Your Grace!
You should take it all off, yeah!
What the hell?
Oh yeah.
Mind it doesn't get wrinkled.
That's what I'm talking about, man. My kind of girl.
Hey! That is silk! Be careful! Give it to me!
Getting interesting. Oh yes.
Your Grace seems right at home in the saddle.
I should have gone there, right? Well, guys, you want to stick around more for more of The Witcher 3 and see the following of this adventure, don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel. And as you are well aware, this is a channel with, yes, an absolute zero subscribers. You know, that doesn't look good for The Witcher. That doesn't look good for Geralt. I mean, I'm trying to follow his story and... Serious subscribers, guys? Like, seriously? Is that what it is? Did I do something wrong? So, please stay tuned and we'll see you next time.